All right, joining us in the studio this morning to clarify what he believes may have been a misunderstanding or misinformation that spread around is former Foreign Affairs Secretary Perfecto Yasay. Welcome to Hot Copy, sir. Thank you for coming to the
Thank
show.
Thank you, and Happy New Year to you, and Happy New Year to
Happy New Year. All right, first let's clarify, because you do have a lot of Filipinos worried, all right? Was data actually stolen? Our data, was it actually stolen by the contractor that was assigned to put up the systems for the electronic passports?
I don't believe so, Karen. And I'll say this very categorically. To begin with, the subcontractee of the personalization system, which is a private entity that was awarded this contract through a public bidding, is François Charles Overtour, fiduciary. Let's call it Overtour for short. Yeah. They were hired, engaged by government through the BSP to set up this personalization system with respect to the production of what we now call as the machine-readable electronic passports, or MREPs. This was to be in compliance with the standards that was imposed by the International Civil Aviation Office, or ICAO, so that there will be a uniform standard in the security of these very, very important travel documents.
And this was in the year?
2006.
During
was
the time
our
of former
President,
Gloria Arroyo. Okay.
And this was a memorandum of agreement that was signed by the DFA in favor of the BSP. Under this memorandum of agreement, BSP will be producing the passport booklets, which are booklets that are bare.
Yeah.
But you need a personalization system to input the data about the information of who will be the eventual holders of this passport. And BSP contracted Overtour to precisely set up the system. The system was finally set up in 2009. But under the terms of agreement, the system was owned, maintained, and operated by the DFA.
So by the Philippine government?
Yes. And this system was kept in the facilities of the Banco Central in Quezon City, a very secured facility.
Yeah.
And a backup system was also kept by the DFA in its offices at Asiana, right? At that time, I do not know if still there now. Now, the Overtour was, however, after it completed the system, continued to assist the DFA and the BSP in the operation and management of this system, because it had some technological features that it was very familiar with, so that it continued to assist the government for free, right? However, for one mysterious reason, in February of 2014, DFA issued a purchase order contract in favor of APO, a government credited or recognized printer, and with the assistance of UJEC,
another private company,
and a private company without, again, any bidding for that purpose, they assisted the government for a fee in the operation and management of this system. Na itsapwera ang Overtour.
So this was the time of former Secretary Alan Peter Cayetano?
No, this was in 2014.
Ah, 14, yes.
Yeah,
I'm
this
sorry,
was still
apologies.
During the time of Pinoy.
So who was Secretary then?
Del Rosario.
Okay.
Albert.
All right.
Yeah. So it happened in this manner. And so when APO and UJEC came in, Overtour withdrew.
Yeah.
After all, it was just assisting the government in the management and operation of the system for free. It had already completed its contract.
Yeah.
But to say now that Obertur ran away with the data is completely false and malicious.
So let's start with this. It was first Foreign Affairs Secretary Teddy Boy Locsin who actually said on Twitter that the contractor ran away. I think those were the exact words.
That's
right?
Correct. In other words, he said he ran away and the DFA could not do anything about it because the DFA was wrong.
Yeah.
All right.
So I want to ask you right now. So first, they were asking first for birth certificates, if you wanted to renew your passport. And I guess when Secretary Locsin was barraged, why, on Twitter, he said the contractor ran away with the data. So first, was Secretary Locsin wrong or misinformed? Why would he say that?
Well, first and foremost, and I'll say he was misinformed. Because first and foremost, Secretary Locsin, in response to the public complaint about why are our applicants for renewals of passport required now to submit their birth certificates to just simply for the renewal of their passports.
Yeah.
So Secretary Locsin said, that is preposterous. Why will you do that? I mean, they already submitted all the, you're just renewing the passport and the passport is still valid. You just have to renew it. So why will you require this new thing? And the explanation that certain officials told him was that, well, because the previous contractor in the preparation of the personalized system ran away with that system, with the data.
Okay.
So it was, to my mind, on that score that Secretary Locsin was misinformed.
Okay. Why would the DFA give the wrong information to Secretary Locsin? What would be the motivation of something this massive in scope?
The only reason or compelling reason I could see is because they wanted to deflect the real issue of the passport mess, which is awarding the production of the passport from an end-to-end basis to APO without any bidding, and APO is a government printer, which APO in turn subcontracted to a private firm known as UJEC in violation of the law.
Okay, UJEC is United Graphic Expression Corporation. Is this a Filipino company?
Yes, I understand it is principally owned by the Subels.
By C. So, I want to ask you this. Was former Secretary Albert Del Rosario, was it questionable for him to actually approve of this contract?
Well, if Secretary Albert Del Rosario was simply informed and given all of the information by the DFA officials who were really in the forefront in the preparation of this contract, then he could also have been possibly misled. But my point is, as I said earlier, the Banco Central had a contract for the production of the electronic passports from 2006, and it was valid up to 2018.
So in other words, there was no need to get any other private company to assist, whether in the systems or printing, because the contract with the French company, Obertur, is technically until 2018.
Well, the contract with the BSP is until 2018, but Obertur completed the creation and establishment of the personalization system in 2009.
Yeah.
But it continued to assist the DFA and the BSP without pay in terms of management and operation of the system up to 2014.
Okay. Before